Hi everyone, I'm Kevin and welcome back to Entrepreneurs Book Club, where I break down my favorite books for entrepreneurs to save you time and help you discover the truly valuable gems that can help you in your journey to become a great entrepreneur. So today's book I'm going to cover, Never Split the Difference by Chris Voss. Came across this book when I was looking for more great sales books to add to my repertoire. But this is a little bit more about negotiation than sales. As you can imagine though, there is a huge overlap between the two topics. So that's why this book is still super relevant. But just before we begin, if you could support me real quick by smashing the like button and subscribing if you haven't already, I would appreciate that immensely. Okay, so what is this book about? Basically, how to become a better negotiator. And if you think about it, we live in a world where you're negotiating on a day-to-day basis in some way, shape, or form. That's why this topic is super important. Throughout the book, the author Chris Voss, a former FBI hostage negotiator, teaches all the different concepts that he's refined over the years. You may be wondering how an FBI hostage negotiation person can teach you anything that translates to the business world, right? Well, you may be surprised because most of the concept translates to any human-to-human interaction out there. In fact, in the book, Voss mentions how he participated in a very famous business school's negotiation seminar and used his skills to top all the business school negotiation experts who have even written books and teach courses on the subject. And by top, I mean that he performed better in terms of the outcome of the mock negotiations that they held among the participants. So there's a ton of different lessons that I learned from this book, but I want to just give you a quick teaser of some of the ones that really stuck with me. First and foremost, he taught me that it's not all about cold hard logic and facts, regardless of how much we want it to be. Just think about it yourself, right? Do you approach every situation with facts only? I know I don't. Many times we let emotions take over, and great negotiators understand this concept. Number two is that finding hidden information is really, really important when doing negotiation. And one way to do this is to get people to talk more by mirroring what they say. Mirror as in like repeat a few words in the main concept of what they say to get them to continue to elaborate. The idea here is that the more they talk, the more they can get to the core of the issue. And if you can understand the core issue, then you can really negotiate better. Number three is that when you're negotiating and someone says no, don't let that discourage you. In fact, that can actually be a good thing because that gives them a feeling of control and power, and now the actual discussion can begin, right? Many times newbie negotiators, like myself even, stop immediately when we hear no, but that's actually better than some forms of yeses, which people can just say to get you to go away and stop talking to them, right? We've all done this before ourselves too. So what did I like about the books? Well, the stories, right? These stuck with me even though I don't remember all the individual concepts and lessons that he taught. I can still recount many of the stories by heart. For example, when he was negotiating with Filipino rebels who kidnapped people and he was negotiating those releases, he was looking for important information he could use to his benefit and found out important info that their true wishes was just to go party on the weekends and spend a lot of money. So he used that timing detail to his favor by negotiating for huge discounts at the end of the week, and then the rebels would just take that money and go blow it on like booze and parties at the weekend. I also remember stories about how he used several of the techniques he taught to get a huge discount when negotiating the price of his dream car down from the original asking price to his asking price. He didn't budge one bit. There was no splitting the difference going into the middle. He got the car salesman to go all the way down to his price, which is really impressive. And that story stuck with me a lot as well. In fact, I kind of want to try it at a car dealership now next time I need to buy a car. Besides those resonating stories, all the specific concepts and lessons were really golden, and I've been trying to incorporate them slowly into my day-to-day interactions. But there are some things I didn't like about the book though. Sometimes I feel like he'd provide a little bit too much unnecessary background and recap previous points too much, when I think he could have jumped into the concept a little bit sooner. This made the structure and flow feel kind of random and confusing at some parts of the books. But overall, I really, really like this book and continue to revisit it because I need it on a day-to-day basis after all. This book really lived up to its hype because I saw it on some lists about like best books to read for entrepreneurs. So I recommend every single entrepreneur to read it. After all, you can use it when dealing with clients, vendors, your own employees, negotiating terms of deals, and so forth. Next on my list for Entrepreneurs Book Club, I'm going to make some videos and reviews for books on product development and marketing. But I'm a huge fan of all of these sales books that I've read so far. So if you have other ones that you really like, then please let me know down in the comments below and I'll be sure to check them out next. So that's all, folks. I hope you really enjoyed this book review and get a chance to check out this book if you haven't already. And as always, let me know your thoughts down in the comment sections below. Give me a like if you haven't already. I'll see you guys next time.